really think you should be. Hello everybody, it's Gary here and welcome back to another Paragon video. You're getting two Paragon videos in 2 days. How lucky are you lot? And today, as you can see, I'm playing as Twinblast with his complete and utter rework on Paragon. They've made him ridiculously overpowered, like he was at the very start of Paragon. And when I started playing it, I loved him. He was my main. So yeah, he's got all these, not new abilities, they're the same abilities, but his ult fires like a Gatling gun, which fires like rapid fire bullets. His rapid fire fires, I think it's 3 or 4 quick fire shots. He's got his same grenade, which you can launch, I think it's 2 or 3 of them, one after the other, which is really handy. And his jump away, I can't remember what it's called, what's it called? Rocket dash, there we go. Which is his escape or his means to get closer. I'm loving the new Twinblast again. The rework has worked so well. You do need much better aim this time though, to be able to use the abilities, because they are rapid fire. His ult, if you miss any of the shots, you're pretty much done. You're not going to hit anyone with it. Just remember to place your wards. I'll show you where is best fit if you're on the right lane. Place it there so they can't get through there. When my other one loads up, I'll put it there. Just going to get the gold buff. This will increase the CXP that you get from minion kills, so make sure that you get this. Get your support to help you, because look at the damage it did to steel. That would have killed me quite easily. As I said in the Murdoch video, do not overextend. Don't push too far forward unless you've got some help, because you will die. The map's so small that you can be ganked really quickly on this one. So just watch your back, put your wards down. Sorry if there's some silences, but I've got to concentrate on hitting the minions, because the movement speed's gone up, so they're really tricky to hit sometimes. Wish the steel would stop hitting stop auto hitting the minions, because it's really hard to hit them. We'll get the last hits on them. Here we go, and I'll show you where the next ward goes. I usually put it here so I can see that path and that path. So I'll normally wait till I've got 6 card points, then go back, because the way the amber works now is that you get one card point when it upgrades. So I'll wait for 6 card points. I see the timer on the grenade, so I can launch another one now. That's really handy. Just loving the new rework. I think they realised that Twinblast was so weak and that no one was using him, so they decided to upgrade him. But I'll normally go with Murdoch or Twinblast. I like them both. I'm obviously a carry. I tried out Chimera and Rampage in the jungle, but I've got no idea what I'm doing yet. There's so many buffs, I don't know which ones are better, which ones are meant to control, things like that, but that will come with time. Two more card points. They want to retreat. It's halfway there. Oh, well done, Steel. Ah, this dude has no idea. He's auto attacking, that's what's wrong. I definitely prefer that rapid fire. It looks so cool as well. Back a bit. The button layouts change as well for some reason. I know you can change them back, but like the rocket dash used to be left click, but now it's E, so that confused me to start with, but I'm alright now. Practice makes perfect. Steel needs to back off. Killed Steel. Ward's down. Remember to ward. I always go on about it in my videos, but you need to ward your lanes, especially in this map. It's so small and you can move around the map so quickly that you need to just make sure that you're protected. That rapid fire is so much more fun. You also need to get to make sure that your aim is on point. I know I've said that, but this is so important with Twinblast now. Because the abilities aim fire so fast, you need to get that sorted. If you're not very good with your aim, maybe carries aren't for you. I mean, Murdoch's still good for slow fire and really powerful shots, but Twinblast will have quick shots that aren't as powerful until late game, obviously. Back, not looking at the map. So fun. Don't know why I love that rapid fire so much, it's just so much fun to use. Stupid. That's one thing you need to notice. If the person that's laning with you starts to move towards you, you're probably about to get ganked. So keep an eye out for their movement as well. If she moves up now, Chimera's on the way back. And he just went back, so I'll ward up again. Steel's back now. Steel, move your fat ass. Yeah, it's a great ult. Could probably take these if I had better support, but I don't really want to risk it. Move forward, Steel. Here we go, finish them off. It's ready now, it's too late. Retreat, back. Fuck's sake. Never mind. Could do with a little bit more. There we go. Amber. So I've got this deck, I've got Flash 5 Pistol Flea Attack Speed, Brand of the Iron Eater because I want to see if Lifesteal's back. There's all my damage. I've got crit bonus because that is definitely back. You want as much crit in your build as you can get. And more attack speed for Twinblast. So I'm going to go with Flash Fire Piston. It's got two Brutal Kinetics and one Kinetic on it. Because you want all that attack speed with Twinblast. Let's put health on as well. Love these things. Boom. So much fun. It seems a lot more arcadey now to me. The Legacy map seemed to be a... it was more tactical than you would have, more ganks and things. I think this one, it's very arcade-like where just like your abilities and stuff, they just seem a bit just arcade. I don't know how else to describe it really. Do with the support. I thought it was level 8 then. It's quite risky going this lane, because if you don't get a good support, you're not going to last very long, I don't think. Steel isn't doing very well for me, I don't think. Not that I would know, because I don't really play support, but I could do with a bit more help on this lane. Put some wards down. Do it then. And that is the ult. Good steal, that's better. Can't see these attacking us here. Just go for the tower steal, stop chasing the kills. Oh, here comes steal. Perfect. And off we go. Gotta go. I'm off steel, sorry mate. Oh yeah, I'm gone. There's Gadget. Well done. It's pretty successful. I'm gonna go to right lane and defend it. Your team composition and how well your teammates play is as important as ever. I don't know how this steel is level 7. You can see the crit bonus is very much back. I used to love playing Murdoch when you could use the crit. Let's get back and get some mana. See how quickly they move now. So weird. Retreat. There you go, back with one more card point. Got no mana. You need some armor or something. How would you go out there? No point in keeping on saying sorry. I've got 6 card points yet, that's annoying. Steel, where are you going? I need help. Very fast-paced gameplay as well. Now I think that's what they wanted to change about it. I think this is more appealing to just normal, I don't know, gamers. I think the title MOBA can put people off, but it's really fast-paced now. I find it more fun. I had a message on my last video saying that someone had given up and they didn't want to play Paragon anymore because of the new map. But you have to just get used to it and keep playing. Seems silly just to give up because the map's changed and the game's a bit different. Let's go and see what I'm going to put on it now. You're going to finish that off or put the brutal kinetics on. I hate how long the mana takes to load up. There we go, Steel's about to die. See, he rushes out and then he's just going to die. Stay under the tower. That's what I thought. This gadget going around the back. Ouchie. Just going for an ult. So what I mean about the aim. If your aim is off, that ult is wasted. It's because Steel pushed him in the air. Why is Steel still out? It's so annoying. Take this if they don't want it. Oh. And that is the escape, which I absolutely love. Let me go back, I think. Quickly finish that off. And then I can get out. Left lane need defending. Sorry, I'm just talking to myself. Just wondering if left lane needed defending. Of course, I'm talking to myself. I'm doing a YouTube video. I'm not talking to anyone else. Apart from you guys, of course. But Steel's like completely left lane now. Doesn't know where he is. Just because I'm here doesn't mean he has to be over here. Do you know what I mean? Just defending the lane. Now right lane's gone. Thanks, Steel. Well done. Where'd they go back then? So I'd like to know what other heroes you want me to play or who you want me to have a go as on Monolith. I've had a go at the jungle. It was pretty good with Rampage. He's just as overpowered as ever. Didn't get on that well with Chimera, surprisingly. I used to really like playing with him. Couldn't really use him for some reason. Not too sure why. surrendering already. We've taken one tower. They've taken two. What's up with you? At least only one person surrendering. Probably the person that dies all the time. With a bit of help. You know the. No, no one fancy helping. Brilliant. Mind trying a support on this map. Obviously haven't used a lot of them on Legacy, but who knows, I could be pretty good with them on Monolith. Just be interesting to know which map you prefer as well. Just leave a comment on the video. I think I prefer Legacy at the moment. I haven't played many games on here. I think I've done better on Monolith than I did on Legacy in the first few games, but I was totally new to the game then, so that's understandable. Here we go, perfect. There you go. We're going for this, it's too dead. We're taking this. What, they've all gone? Where have they all gone? See, they all back, and you need to attack when you've got the chance. It's stupid not. Get the chance to take the tower then, with four of us, because two of them were down, and they all backed, and I don't get why people do that. Go back now with three card points. Finish that off. Nope, not yet. Could probably get rid of the ward now because the lanes have just like totally gone. So I'll get rid of the ward. I know you'll all crucify me for doing that, for how much I go on about them. There's loads of wards down anyway, so I know they're important, but I'd rather have more card points and stuff at the moment. Because no one's really laning anymore. It's all gone. Do with Feng going around the back of him, but I don't think he's going to. Here, don't push forward. Oh. What is Feng doing there? Okay, Countess, I'm not that squishy. Are we going for this? Are we going for it. Are they all backing off again? See, if they all go and defend right, they're right, we can push here. Damage to it. I'm gonna run off, spend these card points. If you can judge where they're gonna go on the map, like their right side tower needed defending then, because you could see the minions pushed up. If you can see that they're gonna send one or two over there, then push forward. Some people don't see that, and they're the kind of things that you need to be able to see on the map. That's why people talk about map awareness is so important, not just for if you're gonna get ganked or there's enemies moving towards you, but it's where they are going to defend and things like that, and where you can attack. I'm not saying I've got the best map awareness, I'm just saying that I'm aware that if I see enemies go towards the left, I can probably attack the middle. Maybe that one needs defending now or not. Finish air off now, easy. Game, motherfucker.
Everything changes.
And get out. Ah, it's so annoying. Forward now. Need to take this tower. Defended that left tower as well, so that was good play from the team. Hopefully we're gonna win this one. It seems for now someone needs to defend right. I'll stay here, defend this one. Let me go back just yet. That crit is so good again, love it. They might be going for all prime. I don't know why they would, they seem pretty eager to get it. Got a lot of crit bonus back up there. Steal again. Come on. Need help. I think I do anyway. Come on then. You know what? I'll take you. Right, what's happening here? Hopefully that tower will be take a lot of damage. Yeah, it looks like it is. point in attacking one, it's 4v5, because they'll just take us all out. See, like Feng here, he's down now. Hold on. It's a small map, but it seems to take forever to get anywhere. Oh my god, how long did it take for those two to come and help then? So little map awareness that it takes so long to come and help. Oh, that's annoying. Never mind, we killed it. So brand of the Iron Eater, lifesteal. Don't think it works yet. I don't think it's found its way back into Paragon just yet. I think I'd rather, and health doesn't seem to be that important either, from what I've seen. You're better off putting, like with Rampage, my two favourites, the Spike Bone Plate and Thorn Greenweave, put them on and they give basic armour, so if you get a basic attack it'll have armour for that. And then I had that snake, it's like snake weave or something like that, snake vine, that's ability armour. So I had two Thorn Greenweaves with the barriers on, two spike bone plates with those guards all the other way around, and then I had the snake vine mesh, I think it is, mesh vine, whatever it's called, and then I had ability armor, so that worked really well. I didn't die, I got about three kills. You just want to, as a jungler, from what my experience, you just want to kill as many of the minions as possible, because that will help to feed your team's amber, so that's really important. You just kill as many as you can. I mix between going to minion camps, so you go to over to the left here and then over to the right, because they'll have five minions in them. If it doesn't go up in stages now, it doesn't go from stage 1 to 2 to 3, it goes up from 1 to 5 minions instead of up in levels, so keep an eye out for that. Also, it's pretty difficult when you start early on to kill 3 or 4 minions, because they will kill you. They attack much faster now. You have a split push somewhere. I don't understand the harvesters anymore either. I don't know how you collect amber from them or anything. It's really strange. They're coming towards me now. Yeah. See, so I've pushed steel out here, so they should be attacking centre. He's gone all the way over there, so attack centre. Steel's just stood there. He's meant to be able to initiate the attacks, and he's just standing still. Gonna get absolutely boned there. There's the ult back. Hit every single one then, I would say. Need to go over here. Hello. Here we go. Right, attack this. Attack. Don't go back, attack. That rhymes. Good shot, Howie. go? Oh, there it is. At least Sev ran off. Thanks, Sev. I know there's nothing you can do, but I just like to be a little bit of a bitch sometimes. So that's my second flats card. And what I'll do is I'll swap out... which one is it? Yeah, this micro nuke with three minor strikes on it. I'll swap that out, which is six card points at the end. Once I've filled the impact hammer up, and I'll get Blade of Agora, which look at that crit bonus. I've got my crit chance in Spear of the Rift Hunter, crit chance in Brand of the Iron Eater, that's got crit chance as well in Impact Hammer, so that's going to make that go up in a ridiculous amount, so watch out for that. Hopefully it'll last that long, we don't make some stupid mistakes. So as long as you can hit all your ult, or the majority of it, it's going to do some damage. Can they not see that invisible countess and I can't? Surely. Don't push too far forward. Some of the buffs, I have no idea what they do. The green one gives you a shield, the pink one makes you invisible, I think. Attack then. Steel doesn't initiate anything. Feng's off somewhere by himself. Steel, what are you doing? God. Has Steel used his ult yet? Steel does nothing. I'm not liking this Steel at all. It's partly my fault. I shouldn't have stayed in and gone for Howie, but I wanted that kill. So, my mistake. But I'm still going to have a go at Steel. Just because I can. Surely he's dead now. Surely he's gonna die now. Thank you. Three card points. Late game, the card points go up so much quicker, so don't worry about it only being one at a time instead of three at a time. They all go up so much faster now. Late game, so don't worry about that. You see all that just went up? If you didn't, go back and rewind. The ammo just went up a whole one, and that's because the jungler, every minion that they kill, it adds to the sort of bank that the team gets every now and then. I think it's every 2 minutes or 3 minutes, something like that. So it's completely changed this game now. It's completely different to what anyone remembers from Legacy. And I'm wondering if they're going to do that every time, just to make it a bit more appealing to more crowds, if you get me. Maybe they were very happy with the amount of people playing it and things like that, so they've changed it. Wow, that's a lot of minions. See the crit damage now, that is well back. I love it. Are we going for this? Need a split push, so if they split push and me and Feng go right, at least one of the towers is going to go down. We're going to get ganked. What is Steel doing? Steel, where are you? Feng, hello! Oh my god, these people. Where's Steel? Where are you? So annoying. Nice one, Steel. Too late now. Just keep running, keep running, keep running, keep running, keep running. Doesn't matter, Steel. Too late. So poor. That one finished now. Yep. So I'm gonna get rid of that and add the Blade of Agora. Yep. That's gonna increase my crit bonus. So the crit's gonna go up so much more. It was on 300 then, but once this card's upgraded, it's gonna start flying up. Are we gonna attack anywhere? Are we gonna go for it? No? Oh, no. Alright, what's gonna happen here? How quick they move, that's infuriating how quickly they move. Need to attack now, come on. Go for it. Need to go for this, hurry up. Prime. All prime now. I bet you none of them will. All prime. All prime. Hello, all prime. Feng. Cool. I can't believe that Twinblast just did all prime by himself. When has that ever happened? That is ridiculous. So, Lifesteal's back. Lifesteal's back. Lifesteal's back. Everyone put lifesteal on your builds because you can take all prime with it. Perfect. I need to go back. So with lifesteal, and I'll have these on now as well. So that's 100% crit bonus. Ah, the tower got taken. That's so annoying. So hopefully we can push forward now. Oh look, what's steel gonna do here? So much damage, look at that. I love Twinblast. Oh my god, such a badass. Why are they attacking middle? Can't go for orb, we'll all just die. Or core, sorry. Where's he going for it? Oh my god, the damage it does. That is absolutely terrifying. And that's that. That late game Twinblast with the orb is terrifying. Anyway, if you enjoyed that gameplay, leave a like on the video and subscribe for more. I'm going to do a few more playthroughs. So remember to let me know in the comments which heroes you want to see me do. I'll try and go through the builds with you a bit better as well. So if you enjoyed the video, leave a like, and I'll see you hopefully tomorrow for a new video. I'll see you next time.